Now to make myself an easy target. Alright, let's do this. Out of the last decade or so, when it comes to pop music, 2012 was definitely the best year of the bunch, offering us a great slew of hits from old acts and new acts alike. I mean, even if you didn't like 2012, you gotta admit, it was a fascinating year. What were once flukes had suddenly taken up a good chunk of the mainstream. We got some good rock, some good rap, some good indie, some good R&B. It was a pretty good year overall. Even some of 2012's more notorious hits weren't really all that bad in retrospect. But of course, that's not to say 2012 didn't have its fair share of bombs as well. While 2012's highs were incredibly high, its lows were also incredibly low. Music in 2014, at its worst, it was boring. Music in 2012, however, was infuriating, mind-bogglingly bereft of redeeming traits and general human decency. Some of the songs on this list rank up there as some of the worst songs ever recorded. Are you ready for this? Because I'm not.
Open Gangnam Style.
Number 10.
Gangnam Style.
Will, I respect you for trying, but you failed.
Oh my goodness. This beat is so hard.
To be fair, this is probably the best song will.i.am has put out in the past few years, because you can almost hear some effort sprinkled throughout. But then again, trying to choose a favorite will.i.am song is like trying to choose the least devastating terminal neurological illness. Like, sure, you can compare them all you want, but that doesn't make them melt my brain any less. No joke, this is some of the most grating synth work I've ever heard on Billboard. J-Lo's chorus is one of the most irritatingly repetitive things that hit the charts since I'm a B. And Mick Jagger has a guest verse, for some reason. Your guess is as good as mine. None of the lines in Will's verses are really all that clever when you think about them for more than 2 seconds, and they're not nearly competent enough to distract from the unfortunate fact that will.i.am basically just wrote a 5-minute song about his dick. Like, there's no denying that. This is a song about will.i.am's dick. That's what the chorus is about. That's what most of the double entendres are about. And trust me, there is nothing I want to hear less about than the untalented cyborg's half-metallic genitalia. And no, Will, talking loudly does not make your lines sound smarter. Quite the opposite, in fact.
Hard like motherfucking liquid swords.
Sword! It is pronounced sword! 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 S-W-O-R-D! Sword! Not sword! Sword!
But hey, you know what's worse than being stupid? Being actively destructive to society.
Real nigga, what's up? Now she want a photo. You already know though, you only live once, that's the motto, nigga, YOLO, and we bout it every day, every day, every day.
Okay, honestly, Drake, I can't tell who's less interested right now, me or you. You know, until now, I kinda figured a song would have to be energetic to result in the deaths of thousands. But I guess I was wrong. This song has pretty much already been talked to death by every other critic in existence, and it's so musically boring that I'm honestly just tempted to show you guys a quick slideshow of tweets containing hashtag YOLO and call it a day. So I'm just gonna do that.
You only live once, that's the motto, nigga, YOLO, and we bout it every day, every day, every day. Like we sitting on the bench, nigga, we don't really play. Every day, every day, fuck what anybody say. Can't see him cause the money in the way. Real nigga, what's up?
See, this is what you two have caused. Oh, right, 3, sorry, I forgot Tyga existed for a second. Number 8. 2012 was a strange year for Justin Bieber. His voice had finally changed, and he finally decided that he'd had enough of being the internet's laughingstock. So he made a partially successful attempt to shed his kiddie pop image and become known as a legitimate artist. Now, this type of change can be a bit risky. It isn't inherently bad, but as was the case with Miley Cyrus, the people who do this are very prone to, well, let's call it overcompensation. And holy shit, was this an overcompensation.
If I was your boyfriend, I'd never-
Nope, worse. There we go. Honestly, I've never really hated Bieber all that much. I would actually defend a good handful of his songs if given the opportunity. But this, there is no defense for this. Everything about this is awful. This is some of the most poorly handled dubstep I've ever heard in a pop song. It's way too heavy to be catchy, and it's way too light to be hardcore. It's trying to sound dark and intense, but just comes off as severely underweight and incredibly irritating. Justin is trying so hard to sound crooning and sexy that he's basically on the verge of tears. The lyrics are absolutely meaningless, basically just a mess of discordant sentences thrown together just to sound good. All they really do is subtract power from the already simpering beat. And Big Sean's guest verse does not fit the tone of the song at all. This is a sloppy, monstrous disaster in all forms. It entirely lacks balance. It's trying to be something that it just simply doesn't have the capacity to be. And its desperate attempts to gain a respectable identity are just painful to sit through. Please, Justin, stop. Do everyone a favor and just stop.
As long as you
number 7. Oh, Nelly, what happened to you? Shit, wait, wrong Nelly. Wow, okay. This is awful. Oh, you want me to elaborate? Okay, it's really awful? Really, really awful? I mean, I guess I could tell you that the production is a clattery mess, the synths are trippy and obnoxious, the lyrics are meaningless and borderline incomprehensible, and Nelly Furtado's vocals are some of the most ear-bleedingly irritating they've ever been, but then I'd just be stating the obvious. This song seems like it was kind of going for an exotic feel, but it just ends up as noise. It's easily the worst song I've heard from Nelly Furtado, and it's possibly one of the most annoying things ever. Yeah, I haven't, and I'm glad I haven't. Next, please. Number 6. Oppan Gangnam Style. Can you blow my whistle, baby? Whistle, baby, let me know. Girl, I'm gonna. Okay, I'll admit, the instrumentation to this is actually pretty good. It's upbeat, well mixed, and catchy to almost an unbearable level, which would be fine if everything else about the song wasn't so terrible. Flo Rida's performance on this song is probably the worst he's ever given. Like, this dude does not have a good singing voice, at all. His vocals are painfully forced throughout. He always sounds like he's one note out of range. Flo's washing machine delivery makes some of the lyrics almost impossible to decipher, and the whistle metaphor is not subtle at all. Like, there's no question about it, everyone over the age of 9 knows exactly what the song's about. You're not concealing anything with this metaphor, you're barely even making the song radio-friendly. You're just adding some really weird imagery to the situation, and possibly giving yourself an excuse to add an obnoxious synthetic whistle onto the chorus. Speaking of which, yeah, that whistle, the one you have stuck in your head right now, yeah, that's the sound of Flo Rida getting a really good blowjob. Have fun sleeping at night. Number 5. And the Academy Award for the most irritating opening to any song ever goes to... And it's all downhill from there. Holy goddamn hell, what the fuck is this? I mean, I knew British pop could get bad, but Jesus Christ and God Almighty. Alright, now I can check Offend Christians off my bucket list. I'm calling it. This is the most obnoxious song of the current century, based on a very surface level of basic social conduct. In this song, Cher paints herself out to be such an obnoxious, selfish, clingy, jealous bitch that I'm honestly inclined to assume it's satire. But really, I don't care whether or not this is satire. The end result is way too annoying to justify its existence either way. Every single element to this production, every single individual element, is grating on a level I didn't originally anticipate was possible. The sparkly percussion, the stuttering bass, the sporadic synths, every little detail just adds to the atrocity of it all. England, it's great that you're trying to share some of your culture with us, but you can keep this one. Number 4. I am so predictable. I get it cracking like a bad bag. Bitch talking shit to queen when she looking like a lab rat. Yep, you all saw this coming. None of you are shocked by this entry. The only shocking thing about this is that it's so low. And considering the last 2 years of my life have been building up to this moment,
I am never reviewing Stupid Ho. I'm not reviewing Stupid Ho. I'm not reviewing Stupid Ho. And no, I'm not reviewing Stupid Ho next. I am not reviewing Stupid Ho. I'm not reviewing Stupid Ho. And I'm not reviewing Stupid Ho. Stupid Ho, a song I will not be reviewing. I'm not reviewing Stupid Ho. Now that I've had to review London Bridge, maybe Stupid Ho wouldn't be that big a step up. Nah, still not doing it.
I guess I might as well take full advantage of the situation. This song was originally created as a response to Lil' Kim's competently written and well-performed diss track, Black Friday. There are two problems. For one, this beat is god-awful. It's unbalanced, it's overpowering, and it's 100% percussion. It sounds like someone took the 5 worst loops in their FL Studio trial and mashed them together at random. With noises ranging from car alarm, to dribble, to siren, to gym teacher's whistle. It's like playing basketball in the middle of the apocalypse. And secondly, the lyrics are pretty much meaningless, ranging from nonsensical metaphors to just plain nonsense, with a bit of racism sprinkled in there. She even admits her own incompetency. So the song is basically the audio equivalent of this conversation. This song has been labeled as the single worst song of 2012 by many, and reasonably so. But after centuries of uninterrupted digging, I've managed to find 3 songs that I would honestly consider worse. Brace yourselves. This is about to get ugly. Number 3. Pitbull's entire career summed up in 5 words.
Now fuck you, pay me.
I know what you guys are probably thinking right now. Oh, this song doesn't sound that bad. It's upbeat, it's catchy, the vocals are alright. It doesn't belong here, especially not higher than Stupid Ho. Oh, how wonderfully naive. Get ready, guys, for the worst drop of the decade. A drop so bad, it single-handedly dive-bombed this mediocre song into complete irredeemability. Isn't that just what you wanted to hear? The death moans of possessed cats, a blender being blended by another blender, a three-year-old child being torn apart by a lawnmower, all these pleasant sounds and more rolled up into one chorus. Worst 15 seconds in pop history, not even joking. Who thought this was a good idea? Who listened to this song and said this is an acceptable product ready for public release? Why would anyone produce this? How does this sound come into anyone's mind? And why would they take time out of their day to replicate it? What possible excuse could there be for this?
Now fuck you, pay me.
Oh right, money. Never mind. Carry on. Number two. Hey Kevin?
Yeah?
Yeah, could you help me out with something?
Oh, alright, what do you need?
Well, since you seem to hate this song more than anyone I know, I was wondering if you could cover it for me.
Sure. What song is it? Ah! Demons! Demons!
Why, thank you, Kevin.
Not done yet. Birthday Cake is hands down the worst song I've ever heard in my life. No song has ever been more abrasive, irritating, or just downright annoying. This could be used as literal torture, it's just that hard to listen to. It's not even with the subtext of one artist beating the other up. The song could have been sang by the sweetest couple you've ever met, and still be the most vile piece of music ever conceived. The beat is just a barrage of loud noises, loosely strung together, one of which is the quite realistic sound of a dentist drilling into your mouth. The lyrics fail at even being just a silly sex jam, because there's no self-awareness to these awful, awful lines. And the vocals clash with the instrumentals so much that they barely feel like they're from the same song. The only good thing I can think of is apparently, someone must have realized the damage they've done, because the song barely even exists anymore. Not on iTunes, Spotify, Google Play, not even as an official release on YouTube. Thanks, whoever did that.
Thanks. Go check that guy out. And now, before we get to number one, some quick dishonorable mentions.
Even the stars.
I'm gonna go out on a limb and say this is the blandest EDM song to have ever hit the charts. I stand corrected. I'm just gonna leave this here.
Yeah, my money insane, nigga. Yeah, I'm making it rain, nigga. Nigga, 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 nigga. I'm 100% nigga.
I done came down, came up, slow pitch, change.
This is like the worst Drake song I've ever heard, but played underwater.
Turn on the light, I'm looking forward to.
Mind-bogglingly awful, but way too stupid to get worked up over. Ew. Number one.
Gangnam Style.
This may seem like an odd choice to some of you, given that songs like this barely manage to crack the bottom five on most lists like these, but I tend to judge a song's ranking on this list not by how much the song angers me, but by how much I don't want to listen to it again. Because the main goal of a pop song should always be to make me want to listen to it over and over, and if you fail to do that, you fail as a pop song. So, with that in mind, my least favorite song of 2012.
Rack City bitch, rack, rack city bitch. 10, 10, 10, 20s on your titties, bitch. 100 deep, VIP, no guest list.
Never has a song given me less of a reason to keep listening to it. Like, I've done a fucking cover of this song, and even I haven't heard it a single time the whole way through. Even taking into account personal taste, what is there to like about this? What is there redeeming about this, and what reason is there to download it? I mean, I guess it's kinda catchy. Almost, if you like, squint at it.
Rack City bitch, rack, rack city bitch.
Nope, still sucks. There's absolutely no draw to this. It's just boring. It's not even especially boring. It's not even particularly terrible. It's just boring. It's nothing but boring. It is boredom in its purest form, comprised of boring synths, boring chants, boring lyrics, and a boring rapper. I have some serious questions for the guy who was told to find a rapper to perform a solo song like this and picked Tyga. There's a reason this guy's been relegated to guest verses. It's because he fucking sucks. He has no flow, no energy, and absolutely no talent. No matter what song he's on, no matter what mood he's in, he always sounds like a teenager talking to his mom on the phone. Right. Yeah. Okay. Right. Okay. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I love you too, bye. I honestly can't tell which is less interesting, Tyga or the beat. Seriously, who could produce something this bereft of good qualities? Of course. I'm the Double Agent, and I've had enough of this shit. See you in a couple weeks.
Catch me!